Hallelujah in this place. Hallelujah in this place. Come on. All over this building. I surrender it all. Come on, if you're declaring that to be true. Come on, why don't you stand to your feet? If you're declaring that you're giving all to God, all that I have, God, is freely yours, and I freely give it to you, God. I surrender all. Come on, I surrender my mind unto you, God. I surrender my heart to you, God. I surrender my lifestyle to you, God. I surrender all, God. I surrender all. I surrender all. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Truly, God is in this place. As I sat there, I could feel the Holy Spirit moving. Y'all made preaching easy tonight. You've invited the Holy Spirit to dwell amongst us. And I thank God for the Spirit of the Most High God. Because where the Spirit of God is, that's where I want to reside. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You may be seated in the presence of God. Truly, I give honor to the shepherd of this house, to this awesome man of God, Bishop Russell Jenkins. I said y'all ought to give thanks for your pastor. Where's New Day at? Where's New Day at? I said you ought to give thanks for the gift that God has given you to your shepherd of this house. Y'all still too quiet for me. The Bible says that this is a gift that's been given to you. Jesus, we thank God from heaven for the invitation to stand behind this sacred desk. I don't take it for granted when someone calls me to tell me to come to give the word. And I thank God for the invitation, man of God. I thank God for the connection that we have made. And I know that we're living in a season where it's just time out for hanging out with just anybody. Come on, I'm talking about divine connections this year. 2017, God is divinely yoking us up together for kingdom work. Thank you, Jesus. I thank God for this awesome man of God, but I also thank him for First Lady Jenkins. I just love her spirit. Come on, y'all. She kept helping keep him sane. Y'all, come on. Thank God for First Lady. She hears all about us. She's the one that keeps him sane, amen? Behind the scenes. She intercedes for him, so we thank you. Thank you so much for First Lady Jenkins and to New Day Ministry. I thank God for this awesome ministry. All the clergy, I would like to acknowledge all the clergy, all the fivefold pastors, apostles, bishops, elders, preachers, teachers, evangelists. If you're in the house, just stand up real quick. I'd like to thank God for you and for your work in the kingdom of God. Come on, saints, y'all need to celebrate the workers. Come on. I preached yesterday that the harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. So I thank God for the laborers. Amen. Amen. To Pastor Lamont Ewell, I thank God for you and your ministry. I thank you so much for his lady. It's for his first lady, my awesome friend. I call her a songbird. Every time she opens her mouth, she shakes the gates of hell. I thank God for her ministry. To my own husband, I thank God for Reverend Vartez Little. Come on, y'all. When God does a thing, he does it well. I thank God for my husband. I thank God for his support. I thank God for his support. And I know the men, and they look at me because I'm the pastor and he's the reverend. But I'll tell you, my husband supports me. He understands the gifting that is in me, the anointing that is on my life. And I thank him because he stands at 6 foot whatever. And I thank him because he's got my back. So y'all don't mess with me. Y'all don't mess with me. Y'all don't mess with me. He's got my back. I thank God for his covering. I thank God for his covering. To my son, he's visiting from Lynchburg University. He's a junior at Liberty, pre-law student. We thank God. Stand up, son. I thank God for him. He came in this weekend because he wanted to come and just be a blessing also, and I thank him for that. And all of my church members, I know all of us are not here, but from Choice Community Christian Church, if you're here, y'all just stand up. I love y'all. I love my church. I love my church. I love my church. I thank God for y'all. I do. I thank God for you guys. Pastor, you know how it is when your members stand behind you. I thank God. I don't care where I go. I got a handful of people traveling with me, and I thank God for them. I do, for the sacrifice they make. Because I'm only as good as a pastor as I have people, amen? This task would be very hard if I didn't have anybody to preach to. So I thank God for Choice Community. Bishop, on this evening, I remember that your theme for this conference is Yet Standing Conference. And it says the dispensation of glory, the next revelation. And I heard y'all had a good time all weekend long. Come on, if you were here over the weekend, just wave your hand. Yeah, see, that's the residue there. That's the remnant from what went on all weekend long. And I thank God for that. So if you have your Bibles, I don't want to prolong you. I know we had service this morning and y'all just shouted yourselves silly already, and I thank God for it. But if you have your Bibles, please turn with me to Deuteronomy, the 5th chapter, verses 23 and 24. I'm going to be reading from the New International Version. I thank God for my deacons and my ministers. I thank God for you guys for coming with me as well. I thank God for you. Deuteronomy. Old Testament, Deuteronomy chapter 5, verses 23 and 24. Standing all over the building, it's our custom to give reverence to the Word of God when it is read. So please stand in all over the building. When you have it, say amen. Come on, let me see where your weapon is. I need you to throw it in the air. Where's your Bibles at? Come on, somebody. Y'all know when y'all were in the world, y'all brought y'all paraphernalia with you. We need to bring our Bibles to church, amen? Let me see your Bible. Hold it up so I can see it. Amen. Y'all don't even have any excuse because y'all got iPhones and iPads. Download that on there instead of Facebook and Twitter and all that other stuff. We need to have the Word of God ready, available. It's our weapon, amen. Deuteronomy, 5th chapter, verses 23 and 24. The Word of God reads as follows. When you heard the voice out of the darkness, while the mountain was ablaze with fire, all the leaders, say all the leaders, all the leaders of your tribes and your elders came to me. Verse 24. And you said, the Lord our God has shown us his glory and his majesty, and we have heard his voice from the fire. Today, somebody say today. Today we have seen that a person can live even if God speaks with them. For this moment that I'm standing before you, I want to put a title on this sermon.
Right.
And my sermon title will simply be, Where's the Glory from Your Story? Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, where's the glory from your story? See, you ought to have a story. You got a story. You ought to give God glory for the story. I don't know what your story is, but you ought to be able to give God some glory for how he brought you out of it, how he brought you through it. Turn to your neighbor and say, I know you got a story.
I know you got a story.
But did you remember to give God the glory?
Remember to give God the glory.
I stand, Lord, asking for your strength and for your guidance, that the people of God might hear a relevant word from you. Holy Spirit, continue to fill this place and to have thine own way. God, I'm smart enough to know that the kingdom belongs to you. I'm wise enough to know that the power belongs to you. God, but let me stand here in my humbleness, God, to give your name back the glory. And the people of God say amen. One more time, I need to hear you all the way on Allison Hill. Say, I got a story.
I got a story.
And I will give God the glory.
Give God the glory
for your story. Come on, clap your hands. Give God glory on your way to taking your seat. You may be seated. What I want to know is, where is the glory for your story? I can't tell your story, but I hope and pray that by the time you leave here, you will learn to give God the glory for your story. See, God's glory is one of those church words that we hear, but we really don't understand it. God's glory speaks primarily to honor and all that's due to God, simply for who he is. We give glory for the role Jesus played at Calvary's cross. His death, resurrection demonstrated God's glory here on earth. The glory of God is the beauty of his spirit. It's attached to God's kingly rule. It's the beauty that emanates from his character and from all that he is. If the truth be told, it's easy to give God praise and glory when things are going good. Come on, when all your bills are paid. Come on, when your relationship is on the up. Come on, when you got a couple dollars in your pocket. It's easy to give God glory. It's easy to give God glory when the mortgage is paid, when the car is acting right, when the people on your job are acting right. It's easy to give God glory when you got your good health and you can see and your diabetes is not all high and your blood pressure is not on running. It's easy to give him glory. But I want to talk about those times when your bills aren't all paid. When you get that pink slip in the mail. When you get that divorce notice in the mail. When those kids are acting crazy. When your man ain't been home for 3 or 4 days. When your child is out there using drugs. This is hard. It's hard to give him glory. It's hard to give him glory. But we'll come in here and act like we got it all together though. How you doing? I'm fine. I'm filled with the Holy Spirit. I'm blessed and highly favored. See, we even got to the point where we're Christians and we get this fakeness, that masking that we put on. See, you can give God that fake glory. You can give him that fake praise. You can give him that fake honor. But he sees through all of that. What about giving God glory in the bad times? When death comes knocking at your front door. When that man says he's done with you, he don't want nothing else to do with you. When your baby daddy walks out on you and he's talking about he's not paying any child support. I'm talking about real things. Can you give him glory when your bank account is in the negative? Can you give him glory?
Amen.
Here in this Old Testament text, Moses pushes the rewind button for the chosen children of God. He restates and revisits the Ten Commandments to the Israelites who seem, my brothers and my sisters, to have forgotten their freedom from bondage, their freedom from Pharaoh, their freedom from his army, their freedom from oppression. They just came out of. How quickly we forget. Turn to your neighbor and say, oh, how quickly we forget. See, they forgot they witnessed God's glory firsthand. They forgot about that glorious Red Sea. They forgot about the glorious Passover. They forgot about the glorious Promised Land. My sisters, my brothers, we can never forget who God is, or we will stop giving him glory. When we put our agendas first, when you make everything about you, because you can sing a little bit. It's about you. Oh, the church service went like that because I sang. Or the church service went like that because I played the instrument. Or the church prayed like that because I prayed. It was because of me sharing my testimony. But let me tell you, church, you can never say, it's not about you. It's not about you. It's not about you. And when we stop giving ourselves the glory, God can inhabit the praises of his people. Then we can see his glory come. I looked at this word, dispensation. And that's just part of your theme, the dispensation of glory. Dispensation to dispense. Y'all know like the soap dispensers, you do something and you get something. You do something and you get something. It means to distribute or to provide, to give, to pass around, to hand out, to dish out. So we're talking about the distribution of God's glory. When we receive God's glory, that's when we can stand. When we we receive his glory, that's when we can stand. See, you're not really standing, you're just functioning. But you can stand when you understand the dispensation that God gives us of his glory. Listen, dispensation is talked about throughout the Bible. It's not just here in this narrative. See, there's a dispensation of glory. There's a dispensation of the fullness of time. There's a dispensation of grace. And the dispensation of minister. It gives me joy now to talk about this new revelation of glory. We sing about it all the time. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Since I laid my burdens down, and for your glory I will do anything. We sing about it, but we're not living it. The Greek word for glory is doxa, D-O-X-A, which means splendor, grandeur, majesty, and glamour. To give God glory means a very great and admiring praise. It's worshiping, thanksgiving. To give God glory means the desire to be in his presence. See, we got a desire to be in other people's presence. You know that woman that's not yours is somebody else's wife. See, y'all get the glory out of being with her. You know that man that is not your man and you know he's married? You can't get no glory out of that. Listen. God's glory is remarkable. It's beyond understanding. It's awesome. It's unimaginable. Extraordinary, stupendous. These are all verbs trying to explain it, because to explain glory is almost trying to describe who God is. That's impossible to do. But anyway, it's not only a material beauty, but it is a beauty that emanates from his character, from all that he is. Listen, glory comes when the barrier that separates two realms of heaven and earth are removed. Let me say that again. Glory comes when the barrier that separates heaven and earth is removed. So the only way to do that is, that's when we come into the picture. We have to remove the barrier between heaven and earth in order to experience God's glory. It's when God in his infinite mercy steps out of his realm into our realm. That's why we often say, Lord, show me your glory. See, we're positioning ourselves to call down the heavens here on earth, and we remove the barrier so that God's glory can be experienced here on earth. When glory hits your life, that heavenly realm will supersede your earthly life. See, then your agenda doesn't become important. See, that's when you allow that heavenly realm to come and inhabit where you are in your lifestyle. See, that's when change comes. That's when transformation comes. That's when deliverance comes. That's when God can do the impossible. But we got to be intentional to call down heaven here on earth and remove those barriers. God's glory will humble the biggest man.
Talk about that.
I don't care how many degrees you have behind your name. I don't care what your title is. I don't care what your position is. God's glory will humble you if you're open to it. The glory of God upon your life will promote you. The glory of God will make nations honor and celebrate you. The glory of God will cause your greatest enemy to bow down before you. God's glory will open shut doors and will make a way for unusual favor. Turn to your neighbor and say, it'll make room for unusual favor. I'm talking about the glory of God that will cause you to stand. Thinking about this dispensational glory. You know, God giving us, dispensing, giving us his glory. See, because we've done nothing, Pastor, to deserve God's glory. I mean, I know y'all might have been to school. nothing that you have done. Say nothing. No church can ever say there ain't nothing you have done that will make you deserving of God's glory. But when I looked at this glory, when I looked at the glory of God, when the glory of God is present, Pastor, when the glory of God is present, there are three elements that are at work. Can I tell y'all what they are? There are three elements that are at work when you see the glory of God, like we felt this morning, like this earlier in the service. When the glory of God is present, there are three elements that you can always count on being present. The first one is a witness. Say it's a witness. The second is a wonder. Say a wonder. And the third one is a worker. Say a worker. We got the witness, the wonder, and the worker. Let's unpackage this. The witness. It's found in verse 23. It talks about it. The witness. When you heard the voice out of the darkness, while the mountain was ablaze with fire, all the leaders of your tribes and elders came to me. It says, when you heard. That's how we get the witness, is because you heard something. That's a witness. So what I learned about this, because the witness, those are people that are watching for the glory. The witnesses, they're witnessing God's glory. But what I learned about the witness, though, that there are different people that handle God's glory. See, there are glory snatchers, and there are glory catchers. Turn to your neighbor and say, are you a glory snatcher, or are you a glory catcher? Oh, see, we got too many glory snatchers, even in the house of God. Come on, I'm talking about you leave the service, and before you get to the parking lot, somebody then snatch your glory. Before you even get home, I'm talking as soon as you get in your front door, you are greeted by a glory snatcher. Catchers, the catchers, not the snatchers, the catchers, they increase your faith. They know how to consecrate themselves. They increase your love for God. They triple their prayer life, and they will intercede on your behalf. They spend a lot of time in the Word of God, and they praise and worship God with intensity. Those are glory catchers. Those are glory catchers. And we have to be honest today to say, where are you at in this? Have you been a glory catcher, or are you a glory snatcher? Don't you know, how you calling yourself an usher, and you trying to usher in the presence of God and the glory of God, and you can't even greet people right at the door? Come on, you a deacon, and how are you a deacon, and you still got Sally Mack and everybody else in your phone book? How is it? How is it that we still, I'm talking about glory catchers, people, glory catchers. I want to be a glory catcher, but that means I can't do everything that I want to do. Some of y'all need to put down pornography if you really want to be a glory catcher. Some of y'all need to give up Hollywood Casino and a scratch-all and a mega ball and a power ball. You can't hold God's glory. And don't think because we're standing up here, we care that you leave the church. If you rally, guess what? I might ask you to go ahead and help us out. Rally, snatching God's glory. Because you won't get right. You want to be on the praise team and you live in ratchet. Hey. You a snatcher of God's glory. Don't you know that how you live will give God glory? You either give God glory or you ain't. It's like a woman being pregnant. Either you're pregnant or you're not. What are you carrying? Are you carrying God's glory? Some of y'all are causing people to abort the glory that God has birthed in them because you're mean. You don't never have a kind word to say about anybody. And why does it always have to be about you? It's supposed to be about God. Myself at the Philadelphia catchers. I'm a catcher. I got me a big old mitt, and I'm trying to catch God's glory everywhere I go. I'm trying to catch His glory everywhere I go. I'm standing ready, God. I want Your glory. I want more of Your glory. Just give me more of Your glory, God. Christ must increase, and you gotta decrease. The heavens declare his glory, and the firmament showeth his handiwork. Listen, the second point. The wonder of God's presence. Say the wonder of God's presence. And you said the Lord our God has shown us his glory and his majesty, and we have heard his voice from the fire. See, the heavens tell of his glory. Pastor, you don't have to be some doctor, reverend, nothing. You can just be, I love God. I love God with all of my heart. Listen, I'm not all perfect, but guess what? I know I'm living for God today. I might not be what I want to be, but I thank God I'm not what I used to be. I thank God I'm not on the corner anymore. I thank God I'm not in a bar anymore. I thank God I'm not a hoe anymore. I thank God that I can keep myself pure before God so that he can use me for his glory. God shouts to the clouds. He shouts to the blue expanse. He shouts to the horizon. He shouts to the galaxy and the stars. He's shouting that he is glorious. And all we have to do is open our eyes. Amen. To see the wonder of who God is. Amen. How long are you going to sit where you are? Don't you ever want to see the fullness of God's glory? I mean, how long you going to be like that? Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, how long you going to be like that? Don't you ever want to go higher in God? Come on, don't you ever want to go further in God? Don't you ever want to go deeper in God? Come on, I want to move when God moves me. You have to have a desire for God's glory. We're desiring too many of the wrong things. How is it that we desire everything else but God? We can't do this thing halfway. We desire everything else but God. See, the church has gotten comfortable. Y'all got lazy and fat on the spiritual thing. This little, you give a few hand claps and you do a little couple dances and you felt like you didn't head church. But when would the glory of God come back into the church? When would the glory fill this temple and rest here? Every time you come to church, you should have looked for God's glory. Every time you come on, you can find, listen, you don't even have to be in the church house to experience God's glory. I make my kitchen a place where God's glory can come. I make my car a place where God's glory. All my job, you come into my little kibble, guess what? The glory of God is right here. Did you work somewhere and they coming over to your desk and you had a church in your little cubicle? It's because the glory of God. I broke down the barrier so God is welcome in every part of my life. Amen. Who am I talking to today? The reason why you don't want to experience God's whole full glory is because you want to hang on to your stuff. That means you got to get rid of some stuff. See, you still want to masturbate in private. You still want to smoke in private. And you think you hide it from the pastor. You can't hide it from us. It doesn't matter to us. It matters to God. You'll never realize his glory. See, to see God's glory, his wonder, we must be prepared to go higher. Turn to your neighbor and ask your neighbor, are you even prepared to go higher to experience God's glory? Listen to this. Listen. Your location will determine the level of God's glory that you encounter. Your location will determine the level of God's glory that you encounter. See, anyone in a valley of sin, fear, doubt, disobedience should not expect to see God's glory. Newsflash, if you live in raggedy, you're not going to experience the fullness of God's glory. You're going to have to fake me out. You know, like the old fake me out Michael Kors and fake me out Louis Vuitton. You'll have that kind of glory. You'll have the fake Stacey Adams and the fake Calvin Klein. You'll have that. You'll have that. If you're okay with that, that's okay. Some people are just okay with that. Listen, I'm going to put my husband out on Front Street. I said that I want a Louis Vuitton, and my husband's shirt's high and low. He came across some joker talking about he got a Louis Vuitton for it. And I said, look, I took one look at that joker and said, that ain't real. Listen, and that's how we got to be in the house of God. You got to know this glory that I'm experiencing is the real thing, baby. This glory that I'm experiencing is straight from heaven. And God's all in it. Listen, as long as you keep rising and falling and making a commitment to be steadfast for God, there is little or no glory for you to see. Some of y'all are just content with a little bit of glory. You're content with just a, you know, just a little bit of experience, God. I don't know about y'all, but I'm greedy, ain't I, Pastor? I'm greedy. I don't want to share. Turn your neighbor and say, I'm not going to share the glory. No, not this glory. We got a person. See, there's different types of glory. We got a corporate glory when God comes and swoops us all at one time. And then I got the glory that rests on my life. And the glory that rests on my life, I'm not willing to share that with everybody. Because everybody can't experience the same level of glory that God gives unto me. It's okay to be selfish. It's okay. It's okay to be selfish with your glory. Because see, when God puts us in the room like this all together, we can experience a corporate glory. But there's, honey, there's sometimes when I got to have God's glory for myself to help me get through one day and the next day. Sometimes I need His glory to help me get up in the morning so I can face those devils all day long. Sometimes I need to hear His glory for those family members that don't like you, you don't care. Sometimes I got to have glory in my life and I have to experience it for myself and it's just mine. You know what you say to those kind of people? Get your own. I know where you can get it. Come on, you give them the recipe. You give them the remedy. I know where you can go get it. If you want some of this, the way that you see it, a God is operating to me, come and I'm going to tell you about a man. His name is Jesus. He's the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. I'm talking about glory. And God wants to move us from glory to glory. I'm getting out your way. Listen. Y'all feeling the glory? You feeling the glory? Listen, the last part of that element that you experience is the worker. The worker. It's in verse 24. Pastor's found it. I didn't make it up. It's in verse 24. It says, today we have seen that a person can live even if God speaks to him. See, the thing about this worker, they understand that revelation demands a response. When God's glory is revealed in your life, it demands a response. And when you hear God calling you, you can see the wonders of His glory. It causes you to move into action. When you feel and experience the glory of God on your life, you become a worker of God. Everywhere you go, you want to help people out. Every time you see people in trouble, you want to tell them about Jesus. You become a worker from God. You don't care about coming to 2-3 service on a Sunday. I get up and do 11 o'clock service, come back and get to 4 o'clock service. I see you on Wednesday for Bible study, and guess what? I'm there because I want more of His glory. Come on, the glory of God. You'll become a worker of God. I mean, you don't get tired. Your flesh get tired, but your spirit is full of God's glory. And you'll get to a point that the primary reason that God reveals His truth to us is to transform our lives. And when you have been transformed, you become a worker for God. When you experience the glory of God, you don't have to invite the glory of the Lord into your life, then you can stand. You can stand. Listen, you can stand when you're full of God's glory. You can stand when you are filled with God's glory. You can stand because you have a new revelation. You have a new revelation of who God is. You have a new revelation of who God is. If you really want a new, how many of y'all want a new revelation of God's glory that will make you stand when everything else around you, when everything else around you, when you're full of His glory? Come on, you got to be intentional. Yourself, they gotta go. When you're filled with His glory, your marriage will work. Y'all both gotta be filled with His glory. When you allow the glory of the God to rest over your household, come on, y'all can walk in agreement. You can have peace when you lay your head down at. When both of y'all are filled with His glory, when you say, "Ask for me in my house," you can experience His glory. Maybe you don't know exactly how to give God glory. Simply means you throw your hands up, you throw your head back, you open up your mouth, push the rewind button of your mind, and you give Him the praise that He is due. Come on, Satan has to let you go. Come on, he's got to let you go. He's got to let you go. When you got a made up mind to have a life that's full of God's glory. Come on, maybe you're here today. Okay. Listen, I don't believe God would give us a message like this if He's not intending to bring in healing and restoration. So if you're here today, and you know you're not experiencing the fullness of God's glory, come on, make your way to this altar today. Make your way to this altar. Declare a decree in this place today that I want to experience the fullness of God's glory. Come on, if that's you today, maybe you're here and you don't know Jesus Christ is your personal Savior. Come on, you're not saved. You're not in relationship with God. If that's you today, why don't you just give Him your heart? Confess with your mouth and believe with your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. 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 I want more of your glory, God. Come on, you can be a minister. You can be an elder. You can be a prophet. You can be an evangelist and still desire more of God's glory. When you're filled with God's glory, it just equips you to do what you've been called to do even better. The second call is for the backslider. Maybe you're here somehow or some way you got off this road of salvation. And the truth be told, it doesn't matter what you did. God says, come on back home. Come on back, come on. Come on. He said he's married to the backslider. Come on, I want to get right with God. Come on, y'all, celebrate God. They're coming back, they're coming back. They're coming back, they're coming back. They want to experience God's glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I want to experience God's glory. Come on, we want to pray for you. We want to pray for you that God's glory will just rest on you, that it would move all in you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Show us your glory. Come on, and even if you're standing here today, come on, y'all, pray. Just pray. There's still plenty of room at the altar. Come on, I desire to have more glory.
For your glory.
Yeah.
watches. She wipes his nose with a shirt.
Oh,
spirit. Yeah. What's wrong?
Don't worry, starting them gonna catch up to you after a while.